Hello everyone, and welcome to Tuesday Tabletop Translations. I, as always, am Artemage, and I'm feeling a little bit of the burnout from War Machine, so I decided, let's take a break and play a simple board game. In this case, we will be looking at Small World. Some of you may be familiar with Small World from your friendly local game stores, and for those of you who aren't, Will Wheaton kicked off his series of Tabletop with the game, so you can find a link to that in the description below. Otherwise, we'll get started and I'll explain some of it as we go along here. Now, Small World is overall an area control game. I'm going to give it a 5-player game with the Royal Bonus expansion that I have purchased. I don't feel like buying the other ones right now. Random player will go first, playing against all bots. So let's see how this goes. Alright, so you got the Spirit Wizards, you lucky jerk. Spirit lets you keep an extra race on the table. Normally, at the end of you using a race, you put it into decline, where you take all the race tokens off but one, and then when you send your next race in decline, the old race goes away if there's anything left. However, with Spirit, the only way they come off the board is if they are taken as casualties, like these Lost Tribe tokens are being done. Now, you might be wondering how these areas are being controlled in general. Well, every spot takes a minimum of 2 of your race tiles to take it over. For every extra thing, it adds 1. So these Lost Tribe guys will make it 3. Same with those mountains. In this case where there's... Oh, it's my turn. That's the wrong thing. In this case where there's 2 tiles here, as well as the place, that require at least 4. There could be other modifiers that reduce or make things irrelevant. For example, a hero token. Heroic. Lets you place 2 different things, which are immune to enemy conquest and their racial and special powers. These are the special powers, these are the races, which each have a bonus to them. Now it's my turn to pick a race. So, we get figure out how many tiles we're getting by adding these 2 numbers together. So 6 and 4 for the halflings would be 10. Let's see what I want to kick off with. I think I'm going to spend the 5 to get the ghouls, because you can play them, put them right into decline, and they stick around. Now the clampants stick around. Okay, so we want to put them out right away, and then we'll put everything in decline, or into fortifications. Now let's see how many we can get here. You hold 4, it's a lot of mountains. You hold 3, and of course it's a lot of hills, but your 2 hills are immune, and your 1 is just stacked right up. So looks like we're not going for them. We may as well start somewhere out in the open, take what we can, and give nothing back. Ooh, it's a 1 and 3 if I'll get this one. Yeah, and I get it. So on your last conquest, you can always roll the reinforcement die if you don't have enough. Half the time it is nothing because there are 3 blank sides, and the 3 remaining sides are 1, 2, and 3. Meaning that, depending, it still may not be enough. What? Yeah, we'll go with that. It's not a huge turn, but it's something. Womp womp. Oh, he's stockpiling 1 spot. Probably because, same like with those humans who are heroic, those halfling holes make them immune from pretty much everything. Oh shoot, if he comes down here, oh, I'm screwed. I'm losing that one. Yep. So the sorcerers have an ability where if there is a single enemy tile, right, that's immune. Single enemy tile, they can use their racial ability to once per turn per player change that into a sorcerer. So I just lost a ghoul. Now thankfully, what I do next, there's not going to be one for them to take. Ooh, lucky them. So we put the ghouls into the climb. Everything stays out there. But I get to use them next turn still. I don't know if there's a way to do that better. Like if I can do a conquest and then put them in the climb. I should really try that out sometime. Like, I know I did the first turn one. Oh, he's eating my guys! We're gonna put them both up here in case Blue decides to spread this way, which isn't likely, but let's not invite the opportunity.
Oh no!
Sucks to be them. Alright, so we choose a new race. I think I like this one because it's a lot of them, and the Dragon Rider basically works like the Hero Token or the Hobbit Holes. Alright, so starting with the Ghouls. One and three. Nope. Dragon Master Rex. Well, I want to kick you guys out, so we'll start off there. Let's go for the shirt thing. I think I'm good with our current spread. Not bad. I need to do a lot better though. What's my score presently at? 18. That's not much. Oops, didn't mean to click that. Alright, and the hobbits are eating up those sorcerers and then coming for me. Just leave me alone, you jerks. How did I only leave one there? That was silly. Sorcerers could have turned. Oh, maybe they can only do it to the active race. So, yeah, that doesn't need to be as much a concern.
Oh, no!
Now, if I were the humans, I'd probably go in decline at this point. They're not. Oh, lucky them. Yeah, they can still score decently with that. I mean, that's 13 right there. right, starting off with the ghouls. I think I'll go after, I'll take 4, so I'm gonna kinda defend myself a bit. First, I wanna see if I was right with the sorcerers. Yep, it needs to be the active race, so my ghouls are safe from the sorcerer ability, so I don't need to stock those guys up. Alright. So let's slow these guys down. It's 50-50. Ah, no joy. Stay there, and it's immune to conquest now. Because they could come from either way. It'll cost them. Ones they don't think they have. So let's reinforce it that way. No, I've got an extra one, so we can do that. Not bad at all. Still need to be doing better. Halflings made a good choice. I can get maybe one or two more turns with my Ratman. I don't want to stretch it too long because it does take a full turn to go into decline. Definitely a good call for the wizards. They've got almost nothing left. They'll probably be wiped out due to casualties at this rate. Yeah, that's what I thought the humans would do. It's a good call to shore up anyways. Alright. Oh, gotta start with the ghouls. Shall we dance? 50-50! Yes! Get out of here! My house! Now, if they're smart, they would probably go into decline next turn. They get anything? No, they haven't. I mean, they've got some good space. All in all, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, if I'm counting right. Might be trying to spread out, but right now they're pinned in by some passive ones. So let's just slow them down here. Alright, what's next? Trying to think of my best move here. Might be to try and stomp out some more of the sorcerers. Slow them down from that direction, which means getting up to them. How many have I got here? I've got 5. So I'll take 2 for that, and I can do 1 for that. That's not really a feasible option. So you may as well take it from a player. Not happy. Alright, so redeploy time. Now, why did it go up there? Well, because there's still sorcerers active presently. And I want to make it hard for them to get to everything. Now, they might get this one. In which case, actually. Because that's a mountain, I want to secure that more than I want to secure the open ground. Sixteen. Not bad at all. Puts me at 47. Not great, but it's a good start. They're using their underground ability to travel anywhere there's a tunnel. Oh, ousted me off my mountain. I might be wondering why they're hanging on to four. It's because four of those only count during the aggressive turn. Serves you right. If he had gotten that, he would have gotten one of mine. Ooh, low scoring turn for the sorcerers. Hey, leave my ratman alone. Oh, it's on now. Oh, jeez. Really trying to stomp those hobbits. Let's do some quick math here. Two we can throw out. One, two, three. Pulling five there. Seven there with only two to spread around, but one of them can be the Dragon Master. I think I'm best going to decline with them. Oh, it's three. Okay, I can make better use of that. First, obviously, I don't want to go for that. Let's go for red. 50-50. Ah, no joy. Now, the sorcerers don't go into decline this turn. They're kind of done. That's the last turn I'll be taking with the Ratman. I mean, it's all turn 7, which is the second last turn. We'll be devoted to that. And then we will get one last conquest on turn 8. Not a bad score. My overall score at 59. I'm probably not winning this. Wow, still not going to climb. And he took one of my ratmen.
Oh no!
Good thing I'm going to climb. Ooh, coming right for me. Oh, I was hoping to get that one. Alright, so my ghouls are gone. Only a 5 scoring turn, but I need a new race.
Oh no!
he's sticking with the sorcerer still. Did he start off with that one? I don't remember. Glad he didn't get that. I wish he had gone for the sorcerers, though. Even though at this point, it doesn't really matter. Alright, so we have my last turn. Oh, that stout ability is pretty cool. Mind you, it doesn't help me now. I need to get as many guys as possible. Looks like it's going to be the elves, which are mounted, which will give me extra to use, so... But there's flying dwarves, which is also with any area at all. Let's get a look at the map. Let's see. Mounted is based on... which lands? Hill or farmland. It must be these regions. I can get some decent ones there. I was eating my own guys, though. Or coming in here where the hobbits are. Halflings, whatever. I've been calling them hobbits this whole time. Of course, we could also come in north here. In through this. Flying is absolutely anywhere. And I can get extra for mines. But it's only 8. It's a lot less. We're gonna go with the mounted. Oops, that's the wrong button. It's an extra gold cost, but it's more guys by far. Amazon still get a turn. I think they're the last ones. Oh, I missed an Amazon spot. Alright, we'll do it that way. I'm hoping they're not going to come from the south much. Oh, didn't really do much of anything. Oh wow, sorcerers are taking a last turn as that. I thought they had their turn already. I was hoping they hadn't gotten that one. Just one less point for them. So that should be everyone now. Winner is probably not me. I finished fourth. That was a pretty close game. I mean, B4P ran away with it, but that was pretty close overall. Well, everyone, thank you for watching me on this break of a game. I will be back another week with more Tabletop Translation Tuesdays. Everyone take care.